I always have had chronic pain in my right shoulder. I frequently pose my shoulder like this when I do ultrasound scanning or interventional procedure. Furthermore, I enjoyed martial art training and active exercise when I was young. Would you please guess the pathology of my shoulder pain? I have a capsular limitation and pain in the glenohumeral joint. So, would you consider frozen shoulder? Today, I'll share my clinical experience of extracorporeal shockwave treatment. It is an excruciating treatment, but I wish this treatment would help me to heal. I'm right hand dominant and forced to overuse my shoulder in an inappropriate position. I checked the MRI scan. Let me show you my MRI scan. I found a focal tear with a ganglion cyst in the anterior capsule and focal high signal intensity of the coracohumeral ligament. I understood why my shoulder pain did not improve well so long and tried to inject steroids into my shoulder several times. I cannot afford to close my clinic and get an operation, so I tried to get inject or steroid into my shoulder several times, but it did not improve the pain and limited the mobility. Let me receive a physical exam first. I'm not sure it will cure my shoulder. I hope I can give you good news soon. Please fix the shoulder before checking the glenohumeral joint mobility. I feel pain at the passive abduction test and there is a limitation of motion. The external rotation movement is also limited. Let me show you internal rotation. Please use your left hand to show my arm to the audience. I have a capsular limitation and pain according to an orthopedic examination. Let me show you my left glenohumeral joint mobility. I have no pain and limitation in my left shoulder. Passive abduction. Please observe the scapula's fixation technique to prevent compensatory movement. I would pay attention to the glenohumeral joint movement only. Passive external rotation. Passive internal rotation. Let me show you my external rotation in a supine position. She put a towel under my shoulder to prevent compensatory movement of the scapula. I feel intense pain in the passive external rotation. This position would remove the compensation more effectively. Please compare both shoulder movements. Let's start extracorporeal shockwave treatment. I will use an EMS dolloclast extracorporeal shockwave machine. Like ultrasound scanning, I need a gel to make the probe contact with the skin. The first target is the anterior and inferior joint capsule. According to Syriac orthopedic examination, the pathology is located at this place. It is a radial type. I will introduce you the kind of machine, mechanism, and clinical application of shockwave treatment in the future. Today, you enjoy watching my receive of treatment. The sound is loud, so I'll put down the noise. Actually, it is an excruciating treatment. The target from this position is the anterior capsule and subscapularis muscle and tendon. She said it would be more effective when tightly compressed the probe, but it provokes more pain. The gliding probe would release the tight muscle. The stretching of my shoulder would extend the anterior capsule and increase mobility. It is a rolling technique. It will release the pectoral muscle. Next, move on to the inferior capsule. She put the probe at my axillary fossa toward the inferior capsule. The skin of the axilla is soft and highly sensitive. Consequently, I feel pain in the deep tissue and skin. This position intends to focus on the coracohumeral ligament. I feel more intense pain when she stretched my shoulder more. It'll be boring, so I'll make it fast. Let me sit on the stool. She placed the probe to focus the shockwave in the supraspinatus muscle and tendon. The rolling technique on the suprascapular fossa will release the supraspinatus muscle. Internal rotation of the shoulder will expose the supraspinatus tendon to the shock wave. I'll take more repeated treatment. It is painful. Some patients refuse to get treatment because of excruciating pain. Let's move on to the coracohumeral ligament. My primary diagnosis is anterior labral tear. I realized that several pathologies are mimicking frozen shoulder. The SLAP slap and anterior labral tear are one of them. It is an excruciating treatment, but I wish this treatment would help me to heal. I'm done. Please compare the glenohumeral joint mobility, passive abduction. Passive external rotation. Passive internal rotation. Transiently, it increases my shoulder mobility and reduces my pain. I hope it'll cure my shoulder. Thank you for watching. See you in the following videos.